All right, okay, I'm gonna make a short video here of how to convert a Harbor Freight compression tester into what's really a fairly primitive leak down tester. And so this is the actual compression tester right here. Come up here, here's the part number, 92697. And they do sell an actual leak down tester, but you know, I'm a little skeptical of all their stuff, even though I do own quite a bit. Some of these measuring type devices I am a little bit skeptical of. But making, like I said, a primitive leak down tester is something that can be easily done with this and very cheaply. So first thing we got to do is actually get this gauge off of the little mounting piece right here. And what I do to get it off, I just take an adjustable wrench, slide it onto this piece right there, and then using a 9/16 inch wrench, you have a little bit of a square drive there. And like I said, 9/16 inch wrench, and you just pull it off. So I'll take that off and then I'll show you the next step. We got the two pieces separated here, the hose from the gauge itself. Now this fitting in here, these threads, are 1/8 inch NPT. And what you need is an adapter fitting. 1/8 inch NPT male fitting, and it could be, in this case, a 1/4 inch female on this end, taking a 1/4 inch male, just quick connect compressor, air compressor hose connector. But this end needs to be 1/8 inch. And I got this at my local auto parts store. I think it was about $3, and then I had the quick connect fitting. I got several of them laying around. So we insert this into here and then just snug it down. All right, so I got this tightened down on here, and I can take an air hose. Let me pick that up. I can take an air hose and plug this in like that. But you don't hear any air coming out the end of there. I can hit the little release valve. We got air coming out there. Now the thing is, if you look real close in there, there's a Schrader valve in there. So we got to pull that Schrader valve out. And that's the most important part about this. So let me disconnect the air. Get my little Schrader valve tool. So we get our little Schrader valve out. Let me hook up the air once again. And we got air coming out the end of it. So now we got a very primitive leak down tester. So let's put it on the truck and see how it works. Okay, I've got our little leak down tester connected here into the number one cylinder. And ideally when you're doing a leak down test, I have to remove the cylinder head. I'm pretty certain I've got valve stem seals are leaking. And on top of that, I think I have a head gasket leak. So, but if you're doing this on an engine that you're not going to just take the head off, you want to have whatever cylinder you're checking at top dead center. It's not an issue for me right now, but I do want to make sure the valves are closed. So I've just completely loosened the intake and the exhaust rocker, so I know these valves are closed. And so I've got my air hose, and I've got the compressor, the regulator on the compressor set at about 30 pounds. You don't need to put 120 pounds or 150 pounds or whatever your compressor maxes out at. 20 to 30 pounds should be enough. So we'll plug this in, and I don't hear any air leaking out. So let me tighten down this exhaust valve, and you'll hear some air leaking out of the exhaust port. See, there you can hear the air leaking out of the exhaust valve. If you had a bad exhaust valve, that's what you'd hear. Now, you can also test this. I've got the compressor turned off, so that's why the air is dying down. I didn't want it to cycle on during the video. Same thing would happen for the intake valve. If you had a bad intake valve, you'd hear it coming out the intake port. With a bad head gasket, you could hear it coming out of the water port. You could hear it down in the crankcase if you had bad rings. So this is, like I said, it's primitive. It doesn't show you the percentage of leak down, but if you just want to find a bad valve or a head gasket leak or something like that, this is a good way to do it.